In this video, we will take a look at the slide of dorsal part of the tongue, also called dorsum linguae. This line is stained with modified green trichrome, that means collagen fibers are green, elastic fibers are black, and muscle tissue is red. The oral cavity, including tongue, is lined with protective mucosa that consists of outer epithelial layer, consists of stratified squamous nonkeratiinized epithelium and underlining connective tissue. Here is epithelial layer and deeper connective tissue layer, also called lamina propria. The dorsal part of the tongue is rough due to numerous mucosal projections called papillae. Here it's a better view. The projection of the mucosal here, the papillae. This type is a filiform papillae. The tips of the filiform papillae show keratinization. You can see here on the top of this papillae, it's very pink, red, and this is the keratinization. The taste buds don't present in this type of this papillae. So, located deep in the lamina propria and core of the tongue are numerous tubulocinar serous glands, for example here. The name of these glands is also von Ebner's. The serous cells have round nuclei here and basophilic cytoplasm because of the zymogenic granule in the cytoplasm. Sometimes you can see mucosal cells in the dorsal part of the tongue, for example here, but mostly it's, you can see serous cells. So here it's a mucosal cells with very pale cytoplasm full of mucose. The nuclei are flattened, squamous, in the periphery located, but the serous cells have round nuclei here. You can see round nuclei of the serous cells. Serous cells, and here the mucosal cells. The cytoplasm of serous cells is darker, and also it's visible the duct of these glands lined with one layer of cuboidal cells. Sometimes the bigger duct is lined with two layers of cuboidal cells. Here it's also duct of the serous gland. Here is a nerve fibers. Most of the core of the tongue consists of interlacing bundles of skeletal muscle fibers. This interlacing arrangement of the skeletal muscles gives the tongue of the necessary mobility for phonating and chewing and swallowing of the food. Here it's visible longitudinal section of the skeletal muscle fibers with striation. This is the changing darker and lighter bands, and also peripherally located nuclei. It's also visible in the gross section of the skeletal muscle fibers. Here it's a transitional section of the skeletal fibers, and black nuclei on the periphery here also visible. And in this slide is very good visible muscle spindle. It's here. This is the sensory stretch receptor, and the specialized muscle fibers located in the spindle and surrounded by the capsule. Here is a capsule from collagen fibers, and the muscle fibers called intrafusal fibers in the center of the muscle spindle. So that's all. So the surface of the dorsal part of the tongue is covered with stratified squamous nonkeratinized epithelium, but the top of filiform papillae is keratinized, and deeper located lamina propria consists of collagen connective tissue with fat cells, and deeper located serous von Ebner's glands. Here the serous glands. Here you can see the duct of these glands, one layer of cuboidal cells, and the core of the tongue is from skeletal muscle fibers, and also necessary blood vessels and nerve fibers also. For example, here you can see very nice sections of nerve fibers. So thank you very much for your attention. See you next time.